Some local county officials spent the night listening to residents. It was the first meeting of its kind, all in the hopes of changing the community. It's just one of several ways newly elected officials hope to reach the community as well. Taylor Williams went to the meeting and has more on the story. Taylor.
Residents and county leaders in attendance told me tonight's listening session was helpful and made them confident that Vigo County is on the right path. It was a night of listening and discussion at the Vigo County Library Tuesday, as some county officials held their first listening session with the community.
If we hear more voices and listen to more voices and know more about what the community wants, we're going to do a better job of making decisions.
Vigo County Commissioner Brendan Kearns, County Councilwoman Lisa Spence Bennett, and County Councilman Chris Schweitzer addressed a packed room of residents, answering questions and learning more about what they wanted in a community.
We want to feel comfortable that their county and city officials are listening to them. So I think that kind of interaction just helps them feel more comfortable asking questions. I think we're better off if we hear what people are asking as well as what they have to say.
The topic that took up more than an hour was the lawsuit surrounding the Vigo County Jail and building a new one.
Pretty much 99% of it was focused on the jail, which is a hot topic right now. I was really hoping to hear more things about the community and how we can help, but it shows that we need to get the jail project done and move forward so we can look at how we can improve the community as a whole.
But what many would like to see is a cleaner county.
There isn't one highway that you come in at Terre Haute that's not full of trash.
It sort of surfaces as people littering and trash pickup. That's kind of one of the ways that you hear about it. But I think we really need to focus on community pride.
By continuing to hold meetings, county leaders hope that officials and residents can work together to make Vigo County a better home.
I think people's memory of Vigo County and Terre Haute has been to not have very good, transparent government. So I think it's Brendan's idea and our idea to make it more transparent, especially on social media or in group forums like this. So I think it's very important.
Other topics brought up for discussion: Vigo County's homeless population and bringing better paying jobs to the community. Dana, back to you.
All right, thanks, Taylor. County officials plan to hold more listening sessions in the future. They also hope to include city officials as well.